Hello, I'm Sin with the OSINT Dojo, and in this video, we're going to cover part 2 of my OSINT methodology for usernames. This portion of the methodology is what most OSINT investigators are probably familiar with in regards to investigating usernames. This is where we use the username that we discovered as a pivot point and spider out to see what other information and associations we can find. Now, depending on the specific situation, there are additional tools and techniques that you may need to apply. However, for the purpose of this video, I'm only focusing on those that are applicable for the more common cases. So, the first thing I do is I run the username through some username enumeration tools to see where else this username might exist. Now, there are way too many of these tools out there to try and cover them all, but what I recommend doing is trying a couple different ones and see which ones work best for your use case. I'm starting off here with the What's My Name tool first. So, I'm going to just come up here and enter the username into the search field here, and over here on the right, if you want to filter by specific categories, you can do this as well. But since I want to search all categories for our example, I'm just going to leave that be for now. And so I'll just go over, click the magnifying glass to search, and it's going to run through the websites to see if it can find a match. As you can see, we got 4 matches here total, and I know this isn't everything under the OSINT Dojo name, but I do know that all these links are true positives. So if there's a specific one of these profiles I want to check, I can just simply go up to one of the results, click on it, and it's going to open it up in a new page for me. At this point, I could begin investigating this specific Reddit profile to see what additional information the target may have provided. But let's move on, and let's run the same username through another lookup tool called Check Usernames. This one is also pretty straightforward as well. Just enter the username, click the Check Username button over on the side here, and you'll see the results displayed over at the bottom. Whereas the What's My Name tool didn't really give us any false positives, this tool does in fact seem to give us very many. For example, I know the Dojo does not have a Flickr account, so if I click on this link here to see the actual profile, I can see that this profile doesn't really exist, and is therefore a false positive. Despite all these false positives, this tool did manage to find the OSINT Dojo YouTube channel, whereas the What's My Name tool happened to miss it. At the same time, I know that there are still other profiles that exist that neither of these tools have located yet. So in order to make sure I've covered all of my bases, once I finish running the username through these types of tools, I next do a search for it on a search engine like Google, Yandex, Bing, Baidu, and others. Searching a username through multiple search engines acts as a sort of backup for the username search tools, as they could not possibly catch every single website. Now, there are still some sites that will slip through the cracks, but I do find that using this tends to help catch many of them. So, if we scroll down here, we can see that Google picked up the Dojo website, which no username tool is going to catch. And it also caught the Dojo's Badger account, which we use for our digital badges. Now, if we run over and do the same search at Yandex, we can see it catches some of what we already know, but look at the images here. This is a good example of why we want to compare multiple search engines on the same username. We're going to sometimes get some wildly different results. So, if we open up the Yandex image results here, we can see a few results, none of which are actually relevant. The only image I even recognize here is Nick's Intel's profile photo. So now, let's go try the same thing in Google. We'll just go back to our original search here, go up, and we're going to click on images. Now, we have a lot more images here that are related than what we found in Yandex. Some of these images were posted by the Dojo, while others were actually posted by others who just happened to reference the Dojo in their posts. Always make sure to check the image section when searching a username, as you're going to find some things here that might catch your eye that otherwise would be buried behind many pages in actual search results. Once I've exhausted my search engines, I next move on to try and locate domains that might contain that username. There's a few different tools you can use to do this, but I'm quite partial to Hooksy. You're going to want to select domain keyword from their drop-down list, and then enter your username and click search. I perform this search to see if perhaps my target has registered a domain using their username. As you can see here by the results, the osintdojo.com website appears. Now, if anyone else had registered a domain that contained OSINT Dojo, but used a different TLD, those results would also show up here as well. Once I've located any matching domains, the final check I always like to make is to see if there's any public PGP keys associated. By searching via a username in the public PGP key server, we can find any PGP keys that may have been publicly submitted where the target has used their username in the key creation parameters. Simply type the username in, click on the Do the Search button, and as we can see, there is a public PGP key associated with our username, both as a username as well as one that includes the email address. If we click on the ID right here, it'll open up the PGP key block, which we can then further exploit with Cleopatra if we already didn't have the associated email address. And that's pretty much it. Like I said, some of the more unique cases may require some more specialized tools or techniques, but what I've shown here will cover many of the cases you might run across. I've left a link to all the tools seen here in the description below, and as always, if you have any questions, feel free to reach out to us on Twitter and we'll be happy to discuss.